Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to discuss about API and how it is closely related with Power BI. That is what we are going to check in this video. Let's try to begin with its definition. API stands for Application Programming Interface. It's a connection between computers or between computer programs. That is what it is. So you are connecting two different computers and it's an interface, application programming interface. And it is a type of software interface offering a service to other pieces of software, right? So let us take this example. You have one database and web server. You have a website and your application, right? From a web application, you want to access to this website or database. So API plays over here, right? API acts as an interface between these two softwares, right? This is one application or software, and web application is another software. API plays interface between them. So this is the simple definition of it. So API is an interface, okay? Connection between two computers or softwares. And what is a web API? Web API, the API is exposed in web using HTTPS. You interact, you make applications to interact, then it becomes a web API. So this is pretty much about it and what role it plays with the Power BI. So same concept, you in Power BI, as we need to get data from different applications, it can be a database or file or any other source system. But you have one application that you cannot share the database data through Power BI. The Power BI cannot directly connect to the database, right? Instead, you create a web API, right? And from there, you can get the data. So, say for example, YouTube videos, right? YouTube cannot expose its database to the users because it's more secure. They cannot just like that share the data. And I run a YouTube channel and I cannot directly point to the database. Instead, there is a secure mechanism. I can create an API to connect to my data and then create analytics out of it, right? So this is one typical example where API comes into place, and in your business applications, and you need to be in a position to suggest if there is no way to connect to your source, you should get an idea whether API is an option, right? That is what I am making this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin how API URL will look like. So we are in Power BI now. Like any other data source, do we have any source for API? It is not like that. So it is just a web source, like over here. Once the API URL is generated, right? So you need to no need to bother about this API. Whoever is in the web development part, they are in the position to generate this API URL. So you need to get some API URL. So another one. It's asking me certain things, right? Anonymous, Windows, and basic web API key. So these are the settings that whoever creates your API, right? Those who are in that web technologies, those who are responsible for creating the websites and APIs, they will provide you. So the secure way is to generate some kind of authentication like Windows or web API key. So using this credential, it is unique key through which you can able to connect to that API. And as it is a public API, I'm not providing any access here, just I'm pressing connect. So once you press this, you get this data. So this is how you can able to connect to the sources, like any application that has option to generate an API, you can connect easily. From this point, as you know, you can able to generate the repos, you can remove the unwanted columns, you can keep the columns, whatever you have, then the report generation is as usual. I hope you like this video. Click the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.